In this video, I'm going to show you Bear's search features because you don't always know exactly what you're after, or the thing that you're searching for might not be the title of one of your notes. Life's never that neat. And searching your JDex is a superpower. If you can learn to do this really well, you're never going to lose anything ever again. Because quick open, command O that we saw in the last video, only considers the text in the title of a note. So if there's text in the main note, quick open won't find that. The scenario here is that I remember leaving myself some notes and a to-do about our outdoor watering system, and I want to update them. So let's try quick open and search for water. And you can see that it's found 12.21, electricity, gas, and water, which is where we store our utility bills. But that's not what I want. And it's also found some partial matches based on those characters there. And that's old work stuff, and I know I don't want that. So that didn't work. Now, here's some general advice. I think we've been conditioned to expect that we should find something instantly. And if we don't, we just give up really quickly. Like, when was the last time you checked page 2 of your Google search results? So my advice is just to kind of slow down a bit. Don't panic. If you know you saved something, it has to be there. And this is why it's so important to have one single trusted system for notes. If you start keeping notes all over the place in different apps, you'll always doubt yourself when you can't find something because was it here or was it actually over there in some other app? And I'll show you later in this video how you can help yourself if you discover that you were actually searching for the wrong thing. For now though, we're just going to use search rather than quick open. And the keyboard shortcut is Command-Shift-F. Now there are subtleties here that we'll cover in a minute, but just for now, remember that this shortcut, Command-Shift-F, will search all of your notes no matter where you are. So it doesn't matter if you're in a specific area on the left there or if you have a tag selected or whatever else. Command Shift F always searches everything. So let's search for water. Now note that Bear will search you results where the search text is in the title of the note above the notes where it just appears in the main note. It prioritizes those where it's in the title. So there's our water bill at the top. If we add a few more characters here so we have watering, and that looks better. We've just got a couple of notes, and from here, I can just down arrow, and I'll skim through these for the one we're after. And that's it. It's pretty simple. It's not rocket science. And in this scenario, we've only got a couple of notes, but eventually you're going to have a lot more. So here's how you can refine your searches. So let's take off that ing to make our results more broad again. And you'll see that this has given us this result, which is from an old work project. Now I know for sure that I don't want to see any of that stuff, so I can search just within a tag. To do that, just select the tag. We'll select my life admin area here, and then either Command F, no shift this time, just Command F, or click the search icon here. So now water doesn't find as much, but there's still a bit there. So let's narrow this down. You can select any tag and Command F will search just in that tag. And this is where you can use your Johnny.Decimal structure to your advantage. Because you know this thing is in category 12, where I live and how I get out, where I live and how I get around. That's where watering's got to be stored. So you can just drill into that tag, search for the more generic water still, and that'll find what we need. Another nice way to use search is just to use your Johnny.Decimal numbers directly in the search, because they provide you a really powerful way of filtering your results built right into the title of the note. So let's do Command Shift F, so we're searching everything. And now we know that we're looking for something in category 12. So if you add 12 dot, make sure you include the decimal there, if we search for that, we've basically filtered on that category without having to select it in the sidebar here. And there we go. We did get a hit from that old work project, but overall this is a really nice way to search your system without having to select something first. And if you find yourself using another app, say you're at work, and it doesn't have Bear's tags feature, then this 12 dot trick works anywhere because it's all just text. Bear has this concept of a to-do item, which we'll see later, but for now let's just have a look at how you can use these items in the sidebar again. So if we select to-do and search for water, that will bring it up. There's another shortcut for this. If you put at to-do in your search, which you can do from the Command Shift F search everything box, then it'll filter just notes with to-dos. And then you can type water, and there we are again. There's a whole bunch of these special searches. You can search for stuff created in a date range, the text of attachments. You can just search notes that contain an image, all sorts of stuff. Now that you've got an idea, I'm not going to go over all of them. Bear has an excellent help page for search, which we've linked down below. check that out. Okay, so let's cover a scenario where you really, really can't find something. You've searched, you've been patient, you haven't panicked, and you really just can't find it. So let's say I thought I'd called it irrigation instead of watering. So I'm searching for that and nothing's coming up. Eventually, I find my note. I realize where it was. And sure, I'll probably remember that I called it watering next time, but it never hurts to leave yourself a little breadcrumb. And this is like the idea that if you can't find a physical item, when you do find it, you should put it in the first place you looked for it, because that's where your mind naturally expects to find it. In Bear, we do this using keywords, which are just words that you type in a note. Again, not rocket science. But I always do this in the same way. Be consistent. This introduces the concept of metadata, and that's a word us computer people use all the time, and it just means data about the data. So the time a note was created is metadata. It's not the main data, that's the note. It's data about the note. And keywords are just the same. It's more information about the note. Metadata. Great word and a very powerful concept. So I always put my metadata up in this top half of the note, and I always separate it from the main note with a horizontal line. In Markdown, you get a line by typing three dashes, like this. Your computer might try to turn two dashes into an N dash, and to get around that, you can either just type your three dashes really fast. You can put a space between each dash, and don't worry, that bear's going to turn the first one into a bullet. It'll just figure that out. Just keep going. You can use asterisks instead of a dash. You can use the keyboard shortcut, which is Command-Option-S. Or you can just turn off the smart dashes feature. Either way, the result is a valid Markdown line separator. The Life Admin pack comes with this description of the item, so let's add a blank line after that. And then I like to put my metadata in a block quote, just because I like how it looks. In Markdown, that's a greater than arrow, which Bear instantly turns into a block quote. Bear calls this a quote in its formatting menu, but in Markdown, it's more commonly referred to as a block quote. And that's to distinguish it from something in quotes. And technically, when it gets converted into HTML for the web, the HTML tag is block quote. So then we type the name of the metadata and a colon, and then the data. So this metadata is called keywords, and it contains the keyword irrigation. That's it. Now, if we search for irrigation, we'll find our watering notes. This still isn't rocket science, right? This is just good, simple habits. And remember, this is the whole point of your JDex. All you have to do to remember something is type a few words in here. So get good at this. Make it a habit. Because I'll say it again, this is really important. Search is your superpower. Learn this stuff really well. Okay, we're just going to finish up with some real quick tips. And this has to do with moving around with the keyboard. So the first few all work across your Mac in every app. You should never be holding down an arrow key, or worse, using the mouse to move around in a sentence, right? Total amateur move. Instead, Option and the left or right arrow moves you between whole words. And Command left and right will take you to the very start or the very end of the current line. Command up or down will take you to the very top or the bottom of the file. So you can jump around real fast using those really simple shortcuts. To indent or outdent bullets, Tab or Shift Tab is your friend. And there's a Bear specific feature that can be really handy in bulleted lists. Command Option up and down will actually move the line you're on up or down the page. So start using those if you don't already. It's just a small improvement, but it all helps. Okay, I'll see you next time when we are going to talk about linking our notes together.